Hello my beautiful YouTube and internet friends. Welcome to my channel. My name is Ilona and today I'm doing an intuitive art journal page. What is an intuitive art journal page? Well, it's actually doing what you feel you have to do. So no thinking, just doing. I start by adding a coat of gesso and I feel that I want to do it with my hands. So I'm patting the gesso on with my hands and then dry my page. Well, that looks like a very simple start, but to tell you the truth, it was not. It seems like I have no inspiration whatsoever. And this is going on for several weeks now. I've been out for a while during the summertime and it's always so hard to get back into the groove again. So I sit there and I don't know, my brain doesn't seem to remember what to do. I keep being stuck in my brain, thinking too much and not doing. So that's kind of a barrier that I need to take after being away for a couple of weeks. So by this time I'm thinking it's high time to get out of your head and start playing. So that's when I decided to go for an intuitive page. Just putting out some colors in front of me, some stuff, and I just enjoyed doing. No thinking, just doing. And let the magic begin. Because when I do this, I always get really powerful messages. And this message is so powerful. I really want to share it with everybody. So be sure to stay tuned all the way to the end so you get this message. You see me writing a letter here, and it's a letter to myself. It's a very old technique. I've been using it before and others have been using it. Just write from the person you are now a letter to your younger self, and it can be as a teen or as a kid or whatever age you feel like. And just start writing what you know now and what you can give to your younger self as an encouragement. So pick whatever comes up. Don't do too much thinking, just go write. And don't be afraid of your handwriting, it's just another layer. We will paint over it, so you won't see it. And when you are done writing, check your message and see if there are words popping out. And take a black marker or something that stands out. And just make these words bold. Then I go over it with gesso again. And I think I don't like the gesso, so I'm taking some color. In this case, I have put out a teal color, a metallic gold, and a metallic bronze gold. And then I thought it was too blue, so I went over it with gesso. This page is absolutely not about the end result. It's more about the process and getting back in the groove of creating. So I set myself a half an hour for this page. So I don't have time to pick out the paper that I think that's fits the best or whatever. I just see on my desk what is lying there and using that. So in this case, there is still a piece of book paper with some gold paint on it that I used recently on another project. I'm also adding a torn piece of the page. I work in a really old book, so the pages are really fragile. And this page that I was working on, I ripped a piece off accidentally. And I even add more texture and more ripped pieces onto my page. I also added a little piece of fabric ribbon that was lying on my desk. And then it felt like I needed to add more gesso to my page, just to soften things up, to get it more to the background so it wouldn't stand out that much. In the thinking process, something happened where I was thinking of my younger self and how she was always in the background, had no courage to come forward. Thought she was not worthy enough, others were always better, that kind of thing. kind of broken, not beautiful. I was a bit chubby. And I had a friend who was really slim. Even by then, when I was 6 or 7, I got mocked at that. And I wasn't even fat, I was just a little chubby. But it kind of sticked in my brain. I felt different and I didn't feel I fit in. Oh, you can have all these things in your head about yourself that are not necessarily the truth. And that torn edge, that torn piece of paper, kind of represented me at that age. So I started to tear all my pieces. Everything that's on this page was torn or ripped or not beautiful, not cut exactly like it should be, or just rough edges. And to emphasize that, I started adding my black pencil to it. And not just beautiful little lines, no, just thick, bold. And then added water, made it even more bold. It really should be sticking out. That's how it felt. So I'm adding the black on all my pieces, and even add more pieces. Pieces of paper, torn paper, but also pieces of ripped painter's tape. And mine won't stick that well, so I also add on a bit of glue. And then I also added in a little bit of gold here and there, just where I felt like. Again, no thinking, just doing. At that point, I'm not sure why, but later it all makes sense. And I got this message, you are beautiful. First it was just, you are beautiful. That was kind of halfway the page. And it didn't fit with me on this page. It just absolutely made no sense. I had this page with all these torn edges and these ripped papers, and it was kind of a hot mess, and I got the message, you are beautiful. It just didn't make sense to me at that point. And again, adding those lines to make them stand out. Adding the water again. And after adding the water, I felt like, I don't know, I want to smudge this. And I just put my rag over it and I made this smudges. Just anything to emphasize it was not about beautiful, it was about being rough and being real, kind of. And during the phase where I added the black to my torn pieces, and just to make them pop off the page, then the message came, even with your torn edges. So I really, really love that message. And then it came so together with how I felt as a child and how this page looked. And with the gold, it wasn't like I thought about it beforehand, but gold says to me, you are beautiful, and it's royal, it's like a princess. So the message of this page kind of is, you can even be a princess. Even if you have torn edges, even if you are rough, even if you don't fit the picture of what the world thinks is beautiful, you still are beautiful. Maybe even those torn edges make you beautiful. And I think that's the message that we need to hear. Because in society, the message always is you have to be beautiful. You have to be slim. You have to wear makeup. You have to be a certain way, or you have to look a certain way. Only then you can fit in. You have to do all these things to be beautiful. And I say no. No! You are beautiful. Why? Because you are. You are unique. There's nobody else like you. And only that is making you beautiful as you. So I guess this page is the message that I got, and it's the message that I want to give to you. And I hope that you believe that. You are beautiful, just the way you are. And then finally, I'm adding in pieces of painter's tape. So I just ripped pieces of tape and added them on, so I could write my message on there. You are beautiful, even with your torn edges. Thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day. And I hope you will make an intuitive art journal page for you.